Tim.
It's the morning star drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star drive, you know.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's Thursday, March 17th. And this is the Morning Star Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and make sure to support us on Patreon. So what is happening on this fabulous Thursday? We've got some coronavirus updates, current news from around the world. We'll do a word study on the 316 message, and of course, question and answer Thursday. All right, everyone, how are you doing? How was your 316? It must have been super amazing. Yes, we joined live over here. And actually, for me in Canada, it's still 316, so I have some more celebrating to do. I hope that you guys had an amazing time at your churches with performances, cake, whatever it is. We are celebrating such an amazing day. Tell me how your day went. You know, not just the 316 celebration we watched online, but you know, what'd you guys do at your churches? What'd you guys do on your own? I would love to, you know, hear about what you guys did. So make sure you pop that down into the comments. Yes, it is Thursday. The first day after 316, this is almost like another New Year's, right? Almost at the ending of the week, super thankful that all of you guys are joining us here. And I hope you guys also had an amazing Wednesday service last night. So let's get this day started together here on the Morning Star Drive. Just want to remind everyone, let's build this community. Tell me how your 316 went. Tell me how things are going. I would love to hear it. All right, so 316, what'd you guys do? What'd you guys think about the 316 podcast we had here? And it was, you know, it's because it's 316. I guess more and more people were watching the pod or listening to the podcast, but it was over 2 hours. But it was tons of praise. And, you know, it was kind of like, you know what it felt like? It actually felt like praise leading for me. As funny as that sounds, it was like praise leading. Like, you know, we're going into these different songs and different categories of songs. I really felt like I was praise leading at that time for yesterday's podcast. But I don't know. What'd you guys think of it? I like, well, actually, there's already a lot of comments on it already. I'm glad that we're able to just have a celebration, not talking about the war or anything else, just celebrating, remembering this day more than anything else. All right. So just tell me, pop in the comments. What'd you guys think of the 316 podcast? Well, a lot of you guys did it already. But for those of you guys who haven't, go ahead. You can like other people's comments or whatever it is. I'd love to hear it. I'm sure a lot of you guys also heard about the news that's happening in Korea right now with the slander and stuff like that too. And you know, there was like some type of like YouTube live conference, and you know, I kind of popped in just to check out. You know, my sound was off, but I went in there to kind of check out like what does it look like, right? And I looked in it for about 20 seconds. And it was like, it looked like it was in a classroom, but I know it's in the law, you know, like the Ministry of Law, whatever it was. But I saw, you know, the person there speaking was someone we all know. And I actually, she was like the 11th interview that I ever did on my Sunday edition. So it was quite interesting to see. And then when I was looking online, there was about, you know, it wasn't a very big thing. There was like less than 300 people who are actually watching live. And a lot of them were like the supporters of, you know, that group that are trying to slander. So I was looking into the comment section too, and just like, oh gosh, it's like, yeah, it's like always. Yeah, it's really interesting because it kind of follows suit. My feeling was it follows like the generation that we live in. You know, the generation where it's like social media and there's a lot of hate and people are just like, they have nothing better to do than to comment on other people's miseries or other people like talking bad about other people and stuff. And when I saw that, it was kind of sad though, right? You know, because it's so sad to see something going through this type of thing once again. And it's really weird this time because they're all foreigners. It was really weird. They're all foreigners. I'm like, that's weird. That's like something interesting and new. But the guy that was in charge of it looks like the same guy who was there for 2008, right? So the guy is probably some smart dude because he was able to pull off something in 2008, 2009 when Sunseem went for 10 years. But here he is again, and they're all foreigners. And it's just, yeah. For me, I looked at it for a second. And I was like, God, like, how can they try to destroy, you know, like, honestly, to be honest, I thought it was not a smart move to do it on 316. Honestly, I thought it was. I thought it wasn't smart at all because no one's going to be watching it. And our celebration is at the exact same time, which means that they don't give anyone in Providence a chance to even, you know, have the temptation to look at it. They don't. Right? So it's kind of like, well, I think they kind of dropped the ball on that one. But ultimately, yeah, it's kind of sad to see the news and whatever. But what was really exciting was like watching the 316 podcast and just the excitement and celebration that no matter what is happening in the world, right? No matter what is happening in the world, we are still celebrating. We are still enjoying, right? And this is the history of God. And one thing Sun Tzu said in the past was, if anything, if there was no persecution, then we wouldn't be the history of God because it wouldn't fit the prophecy. So one of the big prophecies is like Matthew 24, verse 9 and 10, which basically says that, you know, like there's be persecution, hated by all nations because of the Lord. And then verse 10 is like, at that time, many will turn away from faith and betray each other. And that's kind of just happening as a fulfillment of the prophecy. So, you know, the more this happens, the more it's fulfilling what the prophecies are saying more than anything else, right? It's not like it didn't happen to Jesus either, right? So it's not really anything new. And I went over the history of persecution on Tuesday. It's something that's happening constantly. So it's not something what we're going to think to ourselves like, oh, it'll never happen again because Sun seemed resurrected. No, it's constantly happening. Even 2,000 years after Jesus died, Christians are still being persecuted. And we had that statistic of almost 100,000 Christians dying per day because because of their faith. So when you look at that, think about this. If it's on average 100,000, right? Let's say 100,000. It's roughly 100,000. Per year, that means it's like 273, 274 people, Christians, dying per day, which in most countries right now is more than the pandemic, right? In the majority of countries, they don't have this many people dying every day. But in Christianity, there's like 374 Christians dying per day for their faith. So if you think about that, you know, that puts a lot into perspective. Like, you can even say now that there's a pandemic of Christians dying, right? So, you know, one thing I do need to tell you guys is, you know, when Sun Tzu talks about faith, it's something that we really have to take into consideration and saying, you know what? It's about standing firm in our faith with absolute faith, not because we're blind, but because of what we've heard and what we've seen. We know, we've seen, we've heard, right? That's why we stand firm in our faith. It has nothing to do with just believe just because. No, because we heard the word, we received the grace and the love, right? We saw. We see Sun Tzu, how he works. When you guys go to Wormundong, this is the crazy part. When you go to Wormundong to see Sun Tzu, like, you might see him for like 4 days straight, but then another group comes in and sees him for another 4 days straight. And then another group comes in and watches him for 4 days straight, which means that if you start to connect all these people together, you kind of look at them like, no, he's not doing this just to show off because you're there 3 days of the year. He's doing this all the time. The reason we have absolute faith, the reason we believe, is because we know, right? We know. We saw what he does and how he lives, and we hear the words all the time, right? So, you know, in my life, Sun Tzu has always treated me well. And those around me, and being a leader, he almost treated other people so well to the point I was jealous. So loving and gracious and merciful, sometimes so much to the point I get jealous because I'm like, here I am working so hard, but then this person here has sinned so much, and then you treat them so well. You know, it's kind of like, you know, that kind of jealousy we have of love. And, you know, we've seen how he lives. And I look at his life and I have absolute confidence. So I really, really hope that all of us here can really bring ourselves to understand even more, right? Satan comes to confuse, but as Sun Tzu says, the Holy Spirit always brings order. Confusion comes when you're uncertain, you're unsure, you don't have that foundation. And what happens is something really crazy happens and you're just emotionally like stirred up. And then your thoughts get crazy because of those emotions, right? And that's something that we don't want to do. As leaders of this history, and I consider every person watching this podcast as a leader of this history, no matter how long you've been in it, and we have to be those that are very reasonable, very logical, strong, right, and confident, even in the things we don't know. And what does that mean? We'll talk a little bit more about that when we get to the question and answer for today. And, you know, today, you know, it's a little bit different because we just had 316, and we have a 316 message plus a Wednesday message. And I just want to go a little bit over that 316 message during the word study, and then we'll do the Q&A for the last segment today, right? So today's Q&A, a very, very simple one. This is the one that probably a lot of us are going to start dealing with, is how do we handle persecution? Now that this news, you know, this YouTube live thing came out, some things are going to happen, come out in the news. I'm even expecting my parents to figure out because they watch Korean TV and stuff like that. But, you know, let's start with, you know, how do you handle this situation now at the family, national, or whatever level? Right? And I hope that is something that we can really, really be able to understand even, you know, that'll be a good question that we can be able to think about for ourselves and to help others who are struggling with that also. All right. Also, tomorrow night we do, no, tonight. It is tonight. Tonight we do have the new Espresso with Sky video. Do you go directly to heaven after you die? Or like, is there a holding place in the middle? So this is kind of one of those cool questions that a lot of people might ask, is the moment and the instant you die, do you go directly to heaven, right? Also, this week's Sunday edition, we met Garrett Van Hoy from the United States. He's in Washington, D.C. right now. And it's a special interview for me because it's the 100th interview. So I hope you guys really enjoy that. And next week, you know, next week, another exciting one. We have a campus member. I'll be interviewing a campus member from Malaysia, Rachel Tan. Very, very cool because, I got stories with her because she evangelized like her mom. Mom and brother just passed, and her cousin passed, and, you know, I've been teaching her, when I was there in Malaysia, I was teaching her father also, but really, really amazing member, so make sure you guys catch that interview next week with Rachel Tan, all right? And just, you know, really inspiring and thankful for all you guys who are doing these interviews and watching them too. It's really inspiring, and it's something that I think that a lot of us will be able to learn a lot from and receive a lot of grace from too. Okay. All right. So let's get into today's music from member artists around the world. And we'll start with the feature artist of the day. We have a brand new song, guys. Think about this. This is the week of 316. We already got, like, there's a third song, third brand new debut we're going to have. And we're going to go all the way to J Root from the Paper Music Associates in Korea. He is second gen. And he's got a song called World of Us. And that's featuring Seungyeong. So I hope you guys will really, really enjoy this. This song is called World of Us. And I believe this is a debut for his song. And then second song is Somni Boys from America. This one just came out yesterday. Them and Dire Wings. We'll play Dire Wings tomorrow, but today, once again, love this song. Somni Boys from America with Alone I Pray. And then last but not least, we have Renee Lai from Taiwan with How Far I'll Go from the Moana soundtrack, and that will be done in Chinese.
You sometimes wonder how tall I was. Just a word of us. Just a word of us. Just a word of us. Oh, oh, oh. Just a word of us. Just a word of us. Just a word of us. Oh, oh, oh.
Myself, so bless me in the morning hours. All the demons test me, but they will never shake me. If I pray, they hate me. If I pray, you love me. Connect with you is the only thing that matters. And honestly, I couldn't be happier. While I'm praying on my knees, I trust you with all my heart. For you always come through for myself, for my family. For myself alone, I pray. Please don't let me down, Lord. I know I can trust you with all my heart. So I'm on my knees, praying for you to always come through. Even if I pray all night, all I want is for your will be done. So I'm on my knees, praying for you to always come through.
I pray to never just settle for good when great is available. Who's the mastermind behind this mind? I give all the credit to God, that's why I'm back. They mad that I made it, I know that the Satans, they hate it. I keep working hard just to make progress. Now I'm on 10, trust in the process, ayy. Look at my efforts lately, I'm setting conditions daily. I'm praying on my knees, so bless me. Please bless me, please bless me. Tribulations always come and go, I would never stop, just always know. Your focus determines reality, stay solid, that's why.
I'm praying on my knees, I trust you with all my heart. For you to always come through, for myself, for my family, on myself alone I pray.
Please don't let me down, Lord, I know I can trust you with all my heart. So I'm on my knees, always come through. Even if I pray all night, all I want is for your will be done. So I'm on my knees praying for you to always come through.
有一个不幸的海洋，没有尽头的避风，那里永远有阳光。不要完成别人给的梦想，我有自己专属脸庞。从我中学会成长，每一个转弯，每一个路段，每一次希望，每一次失望，不管多困难，有什么地方。 是我不能装，我听见地平线的一边呼唤我，不用知道，终点多远，乘着风迎着浪，要的帆不是疯狂，因为谁敢浪，人生是一场考验坚强的流浪。
留在原地是份安全天堂，里面没有悲伤，但我会失去幻想。虽然能和别人一模一样，会有相同的赞赏，但我有定制的主张。每一个转弯，每一个路段，每一次希望，每一次失望，不多困难，有什么地方是我不。
That was Renee Lai from Taiwan with How Far I'll Go from the Moana soundtrack. Before that, Somni Boys just debuted yesterday. That is Alone, I Pray. What a great song. Really love it. And before that, and that is a feature artist of the day, that's J Root from the Pip Music Associates in Korea with World of Us featuring Seungyeong. And that's the first time we're debuting this song on the Morningstar Drive podcast. All right, so let's get into the news going on around the world. Of course, very, very important for all of us, especially with the war going on, understanding what the things we need to pray for and also seeing what God is doing in this world. So first, we're going to start off with the coronavirus updates, which I don't think we're going to be doing for very much longer because no one's really thinking about it anymore because of the war and all these other different things that are happening, like inflation and prices. You know, it kind of shows you what is more important to people right now. But let's take a look at the coronavirus updates, and we do get to see some shifts in what is happening, what God is doing too. Let's take a look at the global numbers. Since the pandemic began, we've had 462.8 million cases with over 6.07 million deaths, and that's a 1.31% mortality rate. Top five countries going by daily death rates. U.S. on top, but guess what, guys? Numbers are down. U.S. is at 901. And we're usually at around 12 to 1,500 deaths in a day in the past weeks, but numbers are down so much. It's 901 deaths with 25,000 cases in a single day. Russia, 558 deaths with 36,000 cases. Brazil, 323 deaths and 50,000 cases. Indonesia in fourth with 308 deaths and 14,000 cases. And once again, this is like 4 days straight. South Korea in the top five, 293 deaths and 362,000 cases in a single day. And we see that, you know, this could be one of those signs that come out of what is happening in Korea, especially with that conference that happened yesterday too, and the things that we really have to think about. Over here in North America, U.S. on top, Canada in second with 49 deaths and 4,200 cases, and then Mexico only 12 deaths and 1,000 cases. All right, so let's get into the news going on around the world, and of course we're going to go into the Ukraine war. So let's track the invasion on day 21 as Russia advances across the Ukraine. Yes, they've slowed in recent days amid mounting casualties, but attempts to encircle and cut off the capital, Kyiv, continue. So let's take a look at developments for day 21, which means it's 3 weeks. Wednesday would be 3 weeks, and that's interesting because it's 21 days until 3/16. But either way, so far, Kyiv's suburbs saw heavy aerial bombardment overnight. Russian naval forces are gathering on the Black Sea near Odessa, supporting troops around Mykolaiv remain bogged down, and siege of Mariupol continues after 20,000 were evacuated. So let's take a look at the north, the fight for the Kyiv in the north. Russian troops have pushed towards Kyiv from the north, with the main advance coming down the west side of the Dnieper River via Chernobyl. But those troops have faced serious logistical problems, with many vehicles running out of fuel, and have faced strong Ukrainian resistance along the way. The closest Russian troops to the northwest of Kyiv are in the suburbs of Bukha and Irpin. It's about 25 kilometers from the city center, but they have failed to cross the Irpin River so far. And that river and others across the city, as well as difficult terrain like marshlands and bogs, have helped Ukrainian forces slow Russian advances so far. And a Russian advance towards the east of the capital has stalled around the suburb of Brovary. That's around 20 kilometers from the city center. Now, Ukrainian generals in the capital have said their focus at the moment is on keeping Russian artillery out of range of the city center, and Russian forces are attempting to encircle and cut off the capital, but large areas around the city remain under Ukrainian control, especially in the south. Now, in the south, of course, as usual, big Russian gains in the south. Russian forces have made rapid gains across the south of the country, advancing east and west from Crimea. In the southeast, civilians remain trapped in Mariupol, a port city of about 500,000 people, which is encircled by Russian forces and has come under heavy fire. So far, Ukrainian forces have managed to fend off Russian attempts on the ground to capture the city. And elsewhere in the south, Russian advances on Mykolaiv in the west have slowed. Now, taking the city is key for the Russians to push forward west towards Odessa. And Russian naval forces off the coast of Odessa have conducted some shelling off the city in recent days, but an amphibious landing would be very difficult and a sign of Russian desperation, according to sources. So Odessa is strategically important for Russia, as it would cut off Ukraine's access to the Black Sea. So that is coming from the south. And advances in the east, fighting continues in the Donetsk and Luhansk regions, where Russian-backed separatists held significant territory before the Russian invasion. And in the northeast, Russian troops have surrounded the city of Sumy, bombed vital infrastructure, and cut off supply routes. A similar attempt to encircle Kharkiv, Ukraine's second-largest city, has been less successful, with analysts suggesting Russian forces there are in short supply of ammunition. Artillery attacks on residential areas of Kharkiv are being investigated by UN prosecutors for possible war crimes. Some other interesting news is Russia's state TV are hit by streams of resignations. right? So a lot of these reporters and people, the announcers, are handing in their resignations as people are denouncing the war in the Ukraine, right? And this is from the Russian TV stations. So Ukrainian President Vladimir Zelensky has thanked many of these announcers, appealing to anyone working for what he calls Russia's propaganda system to resign, and any journalist working in what he calls the fourth branch of power risks sanctions and an international tribunal for justifying war crimes. So some of Russian President Vladimir Putin's biggest cheerleaders on state-run TV have already faced sanctions, including Vladimir Solovyov, who presents a talk show on Russia's biggest channel, Russia One, and Margarita Simonyan, who has accused anyone ashamed of being Russian at this point as not really being Russian. So Russia state-run channels are required to toe the Kremlin line. So who has quit in response to the war? There was this big announcer, Marina Ovsyannikova's, and she had an on-screen protest. And then right after her, three more resignations came to light. In Channel 1, colleague Zana Agalakova quit her job as Europe correspondent, while two journalists have left rival NTV. There's also Lilia Gilideva, had worked for the channel as a presenter since 2006, and Vadim Glusker had been at NTV for almost 30 years. So rumors abound that journalists have also headed for the door at all Russia state TV group VGTRK. So journalists, there's a bunch of journalists, they're all quitting right now because they just completely don't agree with it and they don't want to toe the line saying that this is a good thing, right? So that's what's happening with the Russian war and the things around it so far. In other news, there was an earthquake in Japan. So Japan hit by shock, cutting power to millions. A powerful earthquake has hit northeast Japan, cutting power to 2 million homes and prompting a tsunami advisory for parts of the coast. It was a 7.3 magnitude earthquake, and this tremor struck the same region where a major quake triggered the Fukushima nuclear disaster 11 years ago. And in some areas, it was too forceful for people to stand, and buildings rattled in the capital of Tokyo, AFP reports. Aftershocks are possible in Fukushima, Miyagi, and Yamagata prefectures. And the quake took place around 11:36 p.m. local time, Japanese authorities said. And the country's meteorological agency has issued an advisory for tsunami waves of 1 meter for parts of the northeast coast, with local media reporting waves of 20 centimeters reaching some areas. Now, there were no immediate reports of damage or injuries, but local electricity providers said about 700,000 homes in Tokyo and 156,000 in Japan's northeast had been left without power. Now, Japan's Prime Minister Fumio Kishida told reporters the government is still trying to assess the extent of any damage, and the event was recorded 57 kilometers off the coast of Fukushima at a depth of 60 kilometers, not far from the epicenter of the most powerful earthquake in Japan's history, which killed 18,000 people in 2011. So the devastating earthquake triggered a tsunami and destroyed the Fukushima nuclear plant. That's in 2011, sparking a major disaster after radiation leaked from the damaged plant. Also, North Korea fires missiles, but launch fails, says the South. North Korea has fired an unknown projectile which appeared to fail immediately after launch, South Korea's military said. The suspected missile was fired from an airfield outside the capital, Pyongyang. The airfield has been the site of several launches, including previous tests of what were the U.S. Alleges were intercontinental ballistic missiles, the ICBMs. It comes as North Korea has in recent weeks stepped up its weapons testing. Now, North Korea fired an unknown projectile from the Sunan area around 9:30 a.m. Yesterday, but it is presumed that it failed immediately after launch. This is what Seoul's Joint Chiefs of Staff said in a statement. North Korea has so far carried out 9 weapons tests this year, including what the U.S. claims were tests of parts of a new ICBM, saying they were likely to have been experimental launches before a probable full-range ICBM launch. Now, with a minimum range of 5,500 kilometers, ICBMs can reach the U.S. They are designed for nuclear arms delivery. The U.N. prohibits North Korea from ballistic and nuclear weapons tests and has imposed strict sanctions. North had put a moratorium in place on testing long-range ballistic missiles and nuclear tests after talks with then-President Donald Trump. But in 2020, Kim Jong-un announced he was no longer bound by this promise. Pyongyang has, however, maintained that the launches on February 26th and March 4th were focused on developing a reconnaissance satellite. All right, so that is a top news going on around the world, which means we'll get to some sporting news. And yes, we got to get into some hockey because last night, great game. Vancouver Canucks, my hometown team, defeat the New Jersey Devils 6-3. So super happy about this one. And this is good because they're very, very close in the standings right now. Edmonton, they won their game 7-5 against Detroit, which means they're clearly about 3 points ahead of us for the third spot in the Pacific Division. But the wild card, we're not too far away from. Anaheim loses to the Rangers 4-3. Dallas loses, and then Vegas loses, which means those three teams are all around us. So super thankful that we were able to jump ahead last night with those 2 points, which means Edmonton is has 70 points, and they're in third place in the Pacific Division, which means that's like that is the actual, what do you call it? That is the third, that's the place we want to get to. We want to catch Edmonton. But Vegas, they are the second wild card spot at 68 points. And guess where Vancouver is? 67. Only 1 point away from a wild card spot. So I am super ecstatic and happy that we're that much closer to a wild card spot. But of course, we don't want to stop there. We want to get to the third place in the Pacific Division. All right. So let's move into some NBA news. A couple of games happened. We got the Memphis Grizzlies defeating the Indiana Pacers 135-102. Great game. Kyrie Irving of the Brooklyn Nets. Brooklyn defeated the Orlando Magic 150-108. Kyrie Irving with 60 points in 35 minutes. Great job for him. Miami defeats Detroit 105-98. Tyler Hero with 29 points. And Phoenix, number one team in the league, defeats New Orleans without Chris Paul 131-115. Devin Booker, 27 points, 5 rebounds. And 8 assists. In soccer news, we have the UEFA Champions League. Atletico Madrid defeats Manchester United 1-0, which means Manchester United is now officially out of the Champions League. Benfica defeats Ajax 1-0, and Benfica moves on also. Over the weekend, also, we heard that PSG also exited the Champions League too. And you know, you know how passionate people are in soccer. After they exited the Champions League, their training grounds were vandalized. Right, death threats and everything else. But, you know, it's been a while since we've seen both Ronaldo and Messi not in the Champions League quarterfinals. But, yeah, quite interesting. They're both of them are not in it. So, yeah, it's kind of the turning of a you know, new powers coming in. Like, who are the new Messi and Ronaldo, right? We see Kylian Mbappe is one of them. And I'm not sure who else that we can say is way up. Oh, Lewandowski from Bayern Munich. But it's the end of an era. The Ronaldo and the Messi era seems like it's kind of, it's done. All right. So that is the top three news for sports, world news, and of course, coronavirus updates for today, which means we're going to get into the golden time. Yes, it is a golden time, and it is the day after 316. I hope you guys really, really were able to enjoy that day together with the Lord, with the Holy Trinity, just celebrating it. And we're going to get into some things we got to do now. But now that we've received it, now we've commemorated it. But what's next? We're gonna start off with the song "Go Higher and Higher." We gotta get higher, guys. We gotta get higher than we are. We were the day before. We could be higher than the week before and the month before too. So I really hope that all of us here will start off with that praise song "Go Higher and Higher." And then let's make God and the Holy Spirit rejoice, which, yes, we need to do every day. And then we'll end things off with Level Up, all right? So as one body of the Morning Star Drive, let's spend this time giving praise, honor, and glory to the Holy Trinity.
Look at you. You are dazzling, led by the Holy Spirit. You are changing in the best way. Look at me. I'm dazzling, led by the word of truth. I know my destiny is changing. Go higher and higher while throwing out my thoughts. Go higher and higher, taking action on His will. Go higher and higher, beyond the limit. That's how I can really truly love myself in the best way.
Just keep going.
Transforming, awesoming, go higher. Na na na, na 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 na.
Yeah. look at you, look at me. Everyone is shining, dazzling. Walls that block you and me with the Lord will break right through them. When we can do no more, the secret is doing more. There are no limits here, we're not with no limit. Don't stop, it just keep going. You change a lot, so gotta keep growing. Started from the bottom, now we're going to the highest. The Lord, he takes me to the Trinity.
Rise up all the rest,
go high.
Changing for the best,
go high.
Rise up all the rest,
go high.
Changing for the best,
go high.
Rise up all the rest,
go high.
Changing for the best,
go high.
Rise up all the rest,
go high.
Transforming, awesoming,
go high.
Go higher and higher, while throwing out the thoughts. Go higher and higher, taking action on his will. Go higher and higher, beyond the limit. That's how I can really truly love myself in the best way. For sure. Let's climb the highest heights. Go higher and higher.
Don't stop and just keep going.
Transforming, awesoming.
Go high.
We have transformed. We are awesome for sure. Let's climb the highest heights. Go higher and higher.
Don't stop and just keep going.
Transforming, awesoming.
Go high.
But we can, and if here we must go higher. find a new historical page. I'm watching turns through the scroll, but today, cause the word it is a source of power, it's my battery. Level up, go to another level though. A higher class, level only we can go. You and I, every person running with the Lord forever.
And there it is. That is Level Up. Before that was Let's Make God and the Holy Spirit Rejoice, and of course, Go Higher and Higher. And I'm really, really enjoying how we are raising the level of how we're making these praise songs and doing them over. Got the Sumney Boys involved. We got a lot of new singers too. So I'm very, very grateful and thankful for the people who are doing praise, and I think they're doing an amazing and awesome job. All right, so let's get into the word study for today. And of course, we had the 3:16 message by Sunseem yesterday in the afternoon, 2 p.m. Korea time. For me, it was at around 10 p.m. It wasn't too bad because, you know, after watching it, I'm going to have my I have my 1 a.m. prayer too, so it wasn't too bad having it that late. So I was really thankful, like, oh, wow, this actually works out perfectly. And now today, for me over here in America, it is 3:16 for me. So I got a lot of stuff to do. I got to have a big birthday cake and have a birthday party for the Lord. So I hope you guys, you know, like I said, pop it down. What'd you guys do for your 3:16 for your churches and stuff like that too? Would love to hear what you guys did. All right. So let's get into this awesome message, right? And this is a message where Sussie's basically telling us, like, hey, look, you've gotten the message for this week, and that's the big thing. You talk about the three blessings, like, what were the three blessings from the Sunday message? Number one is just to be born, right? Born on this earth was the first blessing. Second blessing was to love and be loved on this earth and with the Holy Trinity, right? And to, you know, and then I think the third one was eternal life. No, material blessings. But the blessing of environment and finance, right? So I was just like, oh, this is so awesome. So that was this week's message. And since he went a little bit into it, but he says, you know, if anything else, the message I have to give to you for this day, it's a day of giving glory to God and a day of thanksgiving, right? Those are the two big things, right? On this commemorative day of the most important day of history, right? If you think about it, the most important day of history. And this is a time all of us get to express our thanksgiving, our love, and give glory to the Holy Trinity. And I hope that a lot of us too, yesterday, for especially you guys over there in Asia, you guys are already on the 17th now, spent that time just having an amazing time giving glory more than anything else, right? So, you know, Sunseem started off with, yeah, you know, this week's message, I told you guys, be thankful to be born in this world. Right? You know, God, and I like Sunseem's attitude when he says, yeah, God created the earth for many people, right? Not just me, but for me personally, I feel that it's just for me, right? And that's like, you know, this is when people can really become, I really feel this is when we can become more thankful. Because haven't you guys ever heard it? Like, people are always saying, like, hey, you know, like, we're the brides of God, but there's like a million of us, right? So how can we be like only for God, but then God has a million and we only have only God kind of thing, right? And that's one of the things that we have to think about is the mentality has to change where Sunseem is also looking at the earth. It's for billions of people. But in his heart and in his eyes, he's like, no, but this is only for me. And this is why he's even more thankful. Like, wow, God, you did this for me. You did this for me. And one of the things we have to think about is it's true because all of us, as we live our lives, our world is only from our perception, from what we know, from what we see. That is our world, right? And this is why we really need to be thankful. Like, and think about it in that way is, yeah, in our world, with my sphere of friends and my environment, wow, God, you did this just for me. And the answer is, it's true. It's just for you. Here is this God taking care of each and every one of us individually. And this is why everything that you have and everything that you're getting right now is just for you. And, you know, Sansip talked about his story that we all know about, you know, how, when he was born with a terrible disease at 6 months years old. And, you know, that's got to be one of the most saddest things. And I think to understand, like, I'm going to tell you this one thing. There's this Korean drama on Netflix called Juvenile Justice. It's really sad and it's really emotional. But you get to really, really feel the heart of a parent. It's about, you know, children who do terrible things and go to court and stuff like that, right? And it's like to understand what a parent goes through to bury their own child, right? Like, you know, they say that the worst thing is for a parent to outlive their own children, right? And mom was only 27 years old. And gonna, you know, do it at nighttime to bury her own child. And like, it's, we've heard this story so many times, but it's really incredible if you put yourself into that real situation. And, you know, she checked one last time. You know, that emotional thing is, let me just see my baby's face one last time before I bury, this 6 month old. And then to see that sign of life with the eyes open, like, that is something incredible. And that's why Sansip can say, you know what? God saved me. I should have been dead, but he saved me. He revived me. He healed me. And this is why I'm always thankful on 316. And this is why we have to also be those that are super thankful about our lives too. And it made me think about my life also is, you know, my family is me and my brother. But interestingly is, my mom had two miscarriages before I did. So my brother was born, I think there was supposed to be a miscarriage before my brother and a miscarriage after. And I thought to myself is, if there was no miscarriage, wow, like, God, I wouldn't even be here. And I was like, God, wow, you really wanted me in this world. And if my mom never had those two miscarriages, I wouldn't even exist. My spirit, my soul, it wouldn't even exist. And I was super thankful to God thinking about this also. So I'm sure, do you guys have any stories like that too? About like God saving your life? I'm not sure, it doesn't have to be when you're born, right? But you know, I'm sure a lot of us have all these stories and we were really, really saved by God. And especially when it comes to our birthdays, because, you know, Sansip is very thankful because that's his day of birth and he remembers that. And I think it's a time that we really have to think about our birthdays too and how we are thankful and grateful during that time also, right? So I hope that we can thank God, right? Thinking about the day that you were born, as Sansip said, and even think about why is the day of the rapture really, really powerful for us too? Because technically speaking, it's the day our spirits went to heaven. So it's kind of like the day we went to heaven or the day we were born, right? Everything before that wasn't guaranteed until we were raptured. So I think that's another thing that's really amazing we can be so thankful about on this day of the rapture. And, you know, we can think about it for the rest. You know, this week is the week of rapture. So think about it even today, if it's Thursday for you guys too, right? God created everything, right? And then human beings, right? This came from the message. And it was the second point. And the whole purpose, we know the purpose of creation is to believe, serve, and follow the man of mission, right? And then eventually when we serve, listen, follow, listen to the words that come from the man of mission, what eventually happens is through that, listening to the word and putting it into action, we become the counterpart of love to God. And we did it. We actually did it, right? We did it. And that's why the rapture has happened. And, you know, now we're loving God for 1,000 years. And it's God treating us as brides for 1,000 years. So I hope that all of us can be thankful. All of us can celebrate with the Holy Son. And, you know, we all heard the word and we're gathered. You know, we all heard the word. We gathered for this 316. So let's just not receive this amazing day in just an ordinary way, right? And it's not about, you know, us giving offering of money or giving like some materials, right? This day was created for us. So if anything else, we need to become that gift. Make ourselves clean into this amazing bundle of love for God. So I hope that, you know, regardless of whether you're still on 316 or the day after, let's continue so that next year will be even more clean than we are this year. And we can really be pure before God's eyes. So let's wash our hearts, wash our thoughts, and wash our actions. Well, isn't that amazing? It's like the message is so pure and so good. And like in light of what was happening at the same time of that event with the thing on YouTube with the like slanders and stuff like that, isn't it amazing how Sunseem, like what he talks about, he's not going to talk about judgment of all these other different things. He just is talking about how amazing this day is and just giving glory to God. So I really hope that all of us too can have that type of mentality. Yeah, bad things are happening, but that doesn't change my relationship with God. Yeah, bad things are happening, but doesn't mean I can't give glory to God. I can't love God more, right? And Sunseem went into this love between us and the almighty, all-knowing, omnipotent, omniscient God is so different from human beings. It's impossible to love God in a human way. And this is why we have to have that spiritual love, that brain love, that we will be with each other all the time. We become one with the Lord. And when we become one with the Lord, just like the Holy Trinity, the Lord comes into our hearts and we go into the Lord's hearts and we become one, right? That's Matthew 19:5. When the two become one flesh, and we have to do that with the Holy Trinity and we have to do it together with the Lord, right? That's the same thing Jesus said, right? I am the vine and you are the branches. You know, if you're broken off, then you cannot bear fruit. And we have to reach that level, right? This is the world where the spiritual realm is a place we can actually become one without literally being next to each other. We go into God's heart and God comes into ours. And as astonishing and as incredible as this sound, that's the rapture history where we become one, right? And to what level have we become one is another question, but it's happened since 7 years ago. We have become God's body. He is the Spirit and we are the body. And the Holy Spirit, the Holy Trinity Spirit is inside of us, right? So I hope that all of us can realize the Word and know the Word and realize about this history. And then we can make this ideal history and rapture even better each and every day. I'm just inspired to see Sunseem in doing this. I think it's incredible. And I really hope that all of us too can raise a level so we don't ever have to let Sunseem go through these terrible things again. So the last thing God told all of us was, make everything clean and interact with me, then I'll love you and make you happy. So I hope that this can be one of our goals. That's the goal. The purpose of creation is to become the counterpart of love with the Holy Trinity. All right. So super grateful and thankful and super just amazed the things that are going on in this history right now. And I hope that we can learn, despite all the things that are happening, and no matter what happens in the future, that's not the point. That's not the major thing. What's the most important thing is that we understand and live the life. Now that we've raptured, let us live with that conviction pushing forward in this history, okay? So that is the word study from the 316 message. I'm very, very grateful and thankful, and I hope that a lot of you guys just received a lot from it too. Okay, so let's get into the song of choice for today. And of course, today is Boy Band Thursday, but we're doing something a little bit different because we do have a song request. And yesterday I missed the request because, there was no song request for 316. So I'm going to do it for today because it's a request someone's actually doing. This is all the way over there in Minnesota in the U.S. This is Chris and his wife are really longtime listeners over here. And they're requesting a song called Bartender from the Dave Matthews Band. Very, very talented band. I believe all of them came from Juilliard School of Music, but really, really amazing. So everyone, please welcome the Dave Matthews Band with Bartender. Thank you.
go. Bartender, please fill my glass for me with the wine you gave Jesus that set him free after 3 days in the ground. Oh, and if I die before my time, oh, sweet sister of mine, please don't regret me if I die. Bartender, please fill my glass for me with the wine you gave Jesus that set him free after 3 days in the ground. Bartender, please fill my glass for me with the wine you gave Jesus that set him free after 3 days in the ground, in the ground. I'm on bended knees, I pray. Bartender, please. When I was young, I never think about it. Now I can't get it out of my mind. Come on, Bella, please, Father, please. Oh, and if all this gold should steal my soul away, oh, sweet mother of mine, direct me at this goal. Bartender, you see the wine that's drinking me came from the vine that strung Judas from the devil's tree. His roots deep, deep in the ground. Bartender, you see the wine that's drinking me was the wine that strung Judas from the devil's tree. His roots deep, deep in the ground, in the ground. Must lie among bended knees. Oh, bartender, please. I never think about it now. I just wanna run and die. I'm on bended knees, oh, bartender, please. Bartender.
And that was Dave Matthews Band with the song Bartender. What an amazing group of artists. They are so talented in all their instruments. Really, really appreciate this song request from Chris Jansen over there in Minnesota of the U.S. of A. All right. So that is a song of choice. Hope you guys really, really enjoyed that one. So let's get into the last segment for today. And of course, things have, you know, moved up. You know, we changed things around a little bit because we have... you know, because we had 316 yesterday and the program completely changed, so we missed a couple of things. So let's get into today's question and answer. And only one question for today. And it is a really important one because, you know, there's like the slander stuff happening in Korea. And I'm sure a lot of you in the foreign countries may not be dealing with this as much as Korea, right? Or if your family is Korean. This is a big question that comes out is, well, we're going to have to start handling persecution again. People get persecuted, families are going to come against them or whatever it is. And I'm not going to say it's going to be like an epidemic of like all these people going to be asked this, but especially for us, we need to be ready to handle these types of situations because it's going to happen, right? And it's going to come out in the news, all these other different things are going to happen, and it makes it a little bit different because you're going to see that there's more foreigners that are involved with what's going on in this next wave of persecution or slander, whatever it is. And it's a good question, right? How do you handle persecution, family or national level? How should we be doing this? And if there's one word that I would use, it would be calm, to do it calmly, all right? And one of the biggest, one of the biggest weaknesses of human beings is when we become too emotional. And what happens is people begin to freak out, people see the news, parents confront them, we're like, oh my gosh, what's happening? And everyone will start to, like, their heart begins to race, and you start thinking of the worst case scenarios, and everyone is like, oh my gosh, what do I do? And what happens is, instead of being calm, you get really intense, urgent, anxious, right? And what happens is, in these times, you're going to make the biggest mistakes. And if you look at it face value, just like, aesthetically, it doesn't look good if your parents or someone asks you something and you're freaking out and nervous, right? Because at that point, they're going to probably think to themselves like, uh-oh, something's wrong. Oh, something's wrong about this place, right? And if I were to tell you guys something to do things calmly, yeah, things might pop up and they are going to pop up. People are going to ask you questions. And like I said, I won't even be surprised if my parents start asking me questions. I won't be surprised, right? But if anything else, we have to handle it maturely. Calmly, maturely, reasonably, more than anything else. And of course, when you look at your parents, when people's parents come against them or family, whatever it is, remember, the most crucial issue, what is the most crucial issue? The most crucial issue is actually not about providence. And you're like, what? Yeah, it's true. The most crucial issue the parents have is you. That is the critical thing. Yes, you know, there's a lot of bad things happening all the time, but ultimately, they're really worried about you, just you, right? So if they ask you something because they're concerned about you and you just freak out and yell at them and get angry and they just get more worried. It'll freak them out, right? In the beginning, what has to happen? We have to be very reasonable. And this is something that all of us have to think about is being calm and confident, right? And don't freak out if you don't know. If you don't know, it's okay. It's okay if you don't know. You just got to handle it like a regular person, right? Even at work, you know, some people freak out when they don't know something at work. No, you just got to ask. Someone says, oh, did you know? Hey, did you know about this? And you'll be like, oh no, I didn't know about it, but let me check it out, right? Yeah, if I don't know, I don't know. Let me check it out, right? You can't expect to be knowing every single thing, but it looks really bad when you're like, oh my gosh, what? No, right? This is when people start freaking out even, your parents will start freaking out even more, right? Ask if they ask you, do you know what the situation going on? And generally speaking, we do, generally, because it's always the same thing. Just be honest. Oh yeah, I heard about this already. Yeah, I heard about it happening last night. And like even for me, when my mom will ask, I'll be like, oh yeah, and I know them, yeah. The five people there, yeah, I know them all. Yeah, I've met them before. Actually, one of them was in my church before. Oh, really? He's like, yeah. And they're like, oh, you know, what's the situation? I was like, well, I think we need to wait a little bit longer to find out what the real situation is. right? And parents are going to be looking at that more than all the other different things, right? They're going to be worried. They're going to be thinking, oh, it's like, oh, no, I understand. You know, we've been through this before. Oh, really? Yeah, we've been through this before. But then how could you still stay there if it's been through all the time? It's like, well, you know, I've had my experiences, and my experiences haven't been nothing like this. And I have only received good things from this place. Now, is it true? If they say, well, don't you know what if it's true? And the answer is, yeah, you know, we can't just sit here and speculate. Right? Speculate. Meaning, like, what if it's true? True, but my question to you then is, what if it's not? Because it could be either or, right? It's not just one answer, like, it is true. We don't know. But what if it's, true? Then, well, what if it's not? So I'm not going to freak out, and I am not going to make a decision hastily based on this. Right? And it's something that I do think, you know, I'll look into. And, you know, you have to rest assured, one of the things that my mom and my dad did say about me is they said, hey, look, we trust you. And we know that you wouldn't be part of this. And I was like, I said the exact same thing. I was like, think about it, mom. I was a pastor. I'm a pastor. And like, I did head leading. Don't you think that I would jump out of this right away if anything like this was happening inside the church? Don't you think that I'd be like, no way? You know, how many people would actually want to stay in that place? You know, I judge and I go by what I see and what I know, right? And there's nothing that says this. And I know that, you know, I'm not saying that I'm not going to investigate it, but just let you know that if there was anything like that happening in my church, there's no way I would stay. There's no way I would. And it's true, wouldn't you guys? Honestly, if you think about it, wouldn't you say the same thing? Is like, oh yeah, there's like, let's just say you're the head leader and then your assistant leader or someone else is like doing like these sexual things with other people. Wouldn't you like denounce it? At least denounce it more than anything else? True, right? And if people get even more freaked out, like, oh, you can't stay there. And the answer is, then why do you stay Catholic? All those crazy things happening in the Catholic Church. Individuals can make, you know, think about it. Just because an individual or some, if it is true, does that make the whole thing bad? Right? So, you know, there's so many cases of this. Think about Hillsong Church. Hillsong Church in the last year had this sexual misconduct and stuff too happening. Did the church collapse? People still go there. God is bigger than all these other different things. So, what we need to understand is when it comes to us helping people and dealing with this situation, we need to be calm. We need to make sure that, you know, prepare people well too, which means that if you know or if you think, have any like inclination that maybe my parents might ask me this or this may come up, get everyone to start practicing. Now, what does that mean? Practicing doesn't mean to make everyone lie, practice lying. No, it means to practice what you're going to say, because when you're in the real situation, sometimes you may sound nervous. You may sound like you don't know what you're talking about, or you sound like you're just getting really defensive, right? But, you know, it's the same as someone speaking in front of an audience or group, right? If they don't know, if they don't practice what they're going to say, they're not going to sound convincing. And sometimes we just need to practice like, hey, you know, don't lie. But I want you to talk normally, and I want you to practice it with each other. Hey, mom. Oh, thank you so much. You know, I'm really thankful. I just saw this, the same thing too. So I'm going to look into it also. Oh, aren't you scared about this, this, and this? And it's like, no, because have I done anything wrong yet? Have I done things bad to anyone else? Have I lived a terrible life? It's like, no, I've only had good things happen to me. But this is something you need to practice, something you're constantly practicing, so that when the time actually comes, you're not going to be like, oh, well, man. Like, once you come out like this, or you sound really nervous, it's just aesthetically, it doesn't look good. It doesn't look confident and calm. And this is why I do think it's something that, yeah, if people are going to actually go through these different types of things, or you think they will, you know, get people to practice it, get people to understand it really well, right? And sometimes people don't believe it. Obviously, they were like going, yeah, we don't believe it, but we just don't know how to express it well. So what happens is, if we don't teach people how to express their feelings well, then when it comes out, it sounds bad. And the parents are not going to be really believe it that well either, right? So I do think, yeah, calmly, confidently, and practice, right? And, you know what you want to say. You know, we feel it. Sometimes we know, you know, it's kind of like when you preach the gospel, you know what you felt during the message or when you heard the 30 lessons. However, explaining it to someone is a different thing. Experiencing it, listening to it is different, and thinking it in your mind, but actually doing it and sharing it is a different thing. And that's something I do think that a lot of people do have to think about and practice and understand in such a way that your mind is running in such a calm manner. It's like, yeah, you're having a real discussion about something serious. You know your parents are serious about it, but they will know that you're serious about it too. All right. So that is the question of the day. And I do hope it's something that you guys can take from. If you have any other advice you want to give when it comes to dealing with this type of thing, go ahead, pop it in the comments below. Would love to hear it too. And I think other people would love to hear that also. All right. So that is the last segment for today on this wonderful Thursday. Hope you guys really, really enjoyed it. Everyone have an amazing Thursday. And we'll see you guys again tomorrow on the Morning Star Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morning Star Drive 117.8. You soaring up with Sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the